fucked up. Cause I don't see either one of us budging.
I'm withholding my anger, though I'd like to be the strangler of this punk-ass little pussy's puny neck. It's my right to insist that he acknowledge my existence, but he just displays complete lack of respect. That's what he says to himself as he uses magazines to trash me, as he sits with both his feet up at his desk, smokes a bag of his weed and starts imagining things, and he just can't see that he's manically depressed. And in his jealousy and envy, it just whirls him in a frenzy, as he turns on MTV and sees my face. He don't exist in this world, so he just twists and he twirls, spirals and spins till he hurls himself into rage. And it's destroying him slowly, cause he does not even know me, even though he sees me everywhere he goes. So he just tortures himself, he has no fortune and wealth, so he extorts someone else to get his dough. And now he's acting like a bully, so he tries to push and pull me, but he knows that he can't fool me, so he's mad. He has no choice but to scream and raise his voice up at me, cause it annoys him to see that I ain't scared.
You ain't no motherfucking
bully,
and I ain't bowing to no motherfucking
bully.
I won't allow it, ain't gonna cower to no
bully.
I'll be damned if I don't stand up to a
bully.
Fight like a man and throw my hands up to a
bully.
And I know it must be fucking with you emotionally.
I'm not trying to make no more enemies, no more unfortunately. There's so many other motherfuckers that just are. They just keep hounding at me now that I'm down with 50. Suddenly now I got beef with this faggot jaw. But his ass is such a puppet, or could shove his whole hand up it and just make him say what he wants him to say. But Shook has Irv on a string, and Irv's so nervous that he says anything to this man to keep him at bay. Now Ja thinks that he's so tough and Murder Inc's the big bad wolf, and they gon' huff and puff and blow our label down. But our building's made out of bricks, so you ain't taking out shit. And dog, you just did a song with Bobby Brown. So now you try to pull the race card and it backfires in your face hard, cause you know we don't play that black and white shit. Plus the stylist you fucked when you was ecstasied up was just a man who's dressed up as a white bitch.
You ain't no motherfucking
bully,
and I ain't bowing to no motherfucking
bully.
I won't allow it, ain't gon' cower to no
bully.
I'll be damned if I don't stand up to a
bully.
Fight like a man and throw my hands up to a
bully.
You must be taking too much.
Now what bothers me the most about hip-hop is we so close to picking up where we left off with Big and Pac. We just lost Jam, Master Jay, Big L got blasted away. Plus we lost Bug, Slank Tongue, and Freaky Ty. It's like a never-ending cycle that just seems to come full circle. Everybody's gotta be so fucking hard. And I'm not excluding myself, cause I've been stupid as well. I've been known to lose it when someone says something smart. But as we grow as men, we learn to let shit go. But then again, there's only so much bullshit we can really stand. We all got reps to uphold. When someone steps on our toes, it's no exception, it goes for every man. But if Irv really gave a fuck about Ja like he claims he does, wake him up and make his boy get off them drugs. But he just keeps feeding him pills, so if that E doesn't kill him, someone from G-Unit will, and I ain't buzzed. Dog, I'm talking to you straight. If the situation escalates any worse, we're gonna lose another soldier to this game. And if I get killed for this rap, I got a million in cash that says I will get you back in Haley's name.
You ain't no motherfucking
bully,
and I ain't bowing to no motherfucking
bully.
I won't allow it, ain't gon' cower to no
bully.
I'll be damned if I don't stand up to a
bully.
Fight like a man.